Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Let's look at a wonderful application of enolate chemistry. The work in this video was reported in the Journal of Medicinal Chemistry by an international team of scientists from across Europe and North America. The leaders of this effort are Dr. Paul Brennan and Dr. Udo Oppermann of the University of Oxford, and the synthetic work in this video was performed by Dr. Vinnie Fagan, also of Oxford. The citation is on the following slides as well as in the video description. Here is our reaction in the upper right. We start with a nitrile and add two new methyl groups. How does this work, and why would I put the word enolate in the title when we don't have a carbonyl? While we do not have a carbonyl, a nitrile is a closely related acid derivative. So let's start in the lower left with a ketone. We can deprotonate at the alpha carbon to form an enolate. I've drawn the enolate as a carbanion, but resonance into the CO pi bond makes it much more stable than a regular carbanion. With resonance, the pKa of the alpha hydrogens of a ketone are between 19 and 20. Now look at the nitrile starting material. Next to the nitrile, alpha to the nitrile are two hydrogens. If we deprotonate one of those hydrogens with base, we will form a new carbanion. And we will use an R group to streamline our drawing. I've drawn it as a carbanion, but resonance into the CN pi bond makes it more stable than expected, just like we saw in the enolate. Resonance with the benzene ring helps even more. With stabilization through both the nitrile and the aromatic ring, the pKa of these nitrile hydrogens is about 12. That's pretty low, certainly acidic enough to be thoroughly deprotonated by sodium hydroxide. The anion, a nitrile enolate, can attack methyl iodide in an SN2 fashion. So we attack the carbon, kick out the leaving group. We will get our new product with the methyl group alpha to the nitrile. If we repeat this process, deprotonate with sodium hydroxide and alkylate with methyl iodide, we will form our final product. This transformation works great with a reported yield of over 90%. What did the researchers at Oxford do with this product? Well, lots and lots. Let's see on a new slide. On the screen, to the far left, we have our previous product. The rest of the screen is filled with a much larger molecule, which was derived from our enolate product. You can see traces of our previous product within the larger molecule. The final molecule, called VinSpinIn, binds a protein called Spin1. Spin1 affects how histone-bound DNA is recognized and interpreted. Spin1 may impact inflammation related to cancer or cancer metastasis. In conclusion, a nitrile enolate alkylation initiates the synthetic route of this large molecule, VinSpinIn. If you want to learn more about the synthesis of VinSpinIn by the Oxford scientists, then check out the reference on this slide or in the video description. Please subscribe, like, or leave a comment. Take care.